Do you know how to add a multi-step form in Power Pages? Hi, this is Vrinka Kumari from KnowHow Academy. Suppose let me take one real life scenario that based on the online job portal website, and that website need a online job application form. So in this, we can say we need to collect the information that related our applicants, and those information include like personal information, educational background and professional experience. So this it will be helpful to collecting the information from our applicants also, and we can select the preferred candidate for the particular role for their requirement in that company. So here you can see I can already create one form, that is online job application form, and in this form I can include three sections, that is personal information, educational information and professional experience. But this form is not look good because there is a scroll down and we can say scroll up, and there is a bad experience in that form is like, suppose you have entered all the required fields and when you click on submit button, there is an error show that you have to first fill the address field also. By the user experience is not good. So there is another features in Power Pages that you can use a multi-step form in Power Pages. So let me show you a demo of multi-step form in Power Pages that I have already created. So here you can see I can create a multi-step form, and that is online job application form, and in this form there is a three section, that is personal information, educational information and professional experience. So let me show you that I can enter these details, and these details can be saved in a database. So let me enter a name that can be Sakshi. After I can enter a Sakshi gmail id, that is sakshi@gmail.com. after let me enter a random numbers, it can be address, that is Delhi. Let me click on next. Let me enter a field of study, that is computer science, higher level of education, bachelor degree, graduation year, it can be 2023. And let me click on next. Let me enter a job title, that is web developer. Company name is, it can be XYZ for now. Let me select employment start date. Let me go here. Let me choose date 20 Feb. Let me choose 4th February, and their employment end date, suppose let me go here and let me choose Feb, and we click on it. And here you can say we can upload your resume also. So I click on choosing file, and let me go scroll down. So let me select sakshi.pdf, and we click on open. And here you can see sakshi resume.pdf can be stored here, and we click on submit. So here you can say there is a multiple step form can be submitted all these records successfully in the database. So here you can see I can create one website that is name is multi-step form, and let me show you that how you can create a multi-step form in Power Pages. So here you can see there is a choose a component to add to this section. So for now we select a multi-step form, and in this form we have to give a form name. So let me take the name of this form, it can be online job application form, and here you can say it can be show a progress indicator also, and it allow multiple entry per person also. For now we click on OK. So it can be show that you can enter a first step, so we click on at the first step, and here you can see we have to give a step name. So let me give a step name, that is personal information. So if you want to create a multi-step form, you have one table, and in that table you have one form. So let me tell you that how you can create that table and that form in multi-step form in Power Pages. So we cross this for now. So let's move to the data, and now we have to create our table, and we click on new table, and I can give the table name, that is online job portal, and let me click on save. So after that we have to change their label name. So let me change into label name, that is full name, and we click on save. And let me create a new column, that is email address. Address, we have to choose our data type, so it can be text, text, and we choose email, and after we click on save. After that we have to create a new column, so I can choose this column name, it can be phone number. So let me select a data type, we click on next, and we choose a phone number, and we click on save. After that we have to create another new column, so it can be address, and let me choose a text, and it can be text area, and we click on save. So let me create a form, so we click on forms, and we go in new form, and let me give a form name, so it can be personal information form, and we click on create. After that we have click on add field, and let me add some field like email address, phone number, and address, and after we go save and publish. So here you can see our first form can be created, and that form name is personal information form. So now we have go on pages and add the first step. Let me give a step name that can be personal information, and choose a table, so it can be online job portal. And let me select a form, so it can be personal information form, and we click on OK. After that we have to give a permission to this form, so we go here and we click on permissions, and here you can see I can created a permission already, so we go on personal information. And after that I can give a information to read the record, to update the record, or to recreate the record. And after I can add roles to anonymous users, and we click on OK, and after we click on OK. And let me cross this, and let me tell you that how you can create a second step in a multi-step form using a Power Pages platform. So let me add another step of the multi-step form. So we go here and click on add step, and here you can see that I have to give a step name, so it can be educational information, and I have to choose a table that can be online job portal. And after that I have to select a form, so I have to create the another form for the educational information. So let me cross this, and we go on data, and let me click on forms, and we have to create a new form, that is educational information. After that we click on create. So here you can see our educational information form can be created. So after that we have to click on add field, and let me choose a column name, so it can be field of study, and it can be higher level of education, and then graduation year. And after that I have to hide this, so we click on hide, and we have to save and publish. So here you can see our another form can be created, that is name is educational information, and in this information there is a three fields, that is field of study, higher level of education, and graduation year. So after that we have to go on pages, and we click on add step. Let me give a step name, that is educational information, and there is a same table, that is online job portal, and let me select another form, so it can be educational information, and we click on OK. So here you can see this can be asked the update information. So it can be, we have to create information in a dataverse, or we can say we have to collect our information in a dataverse. So I have to go here, you click on step setting, and let me go in more option, and I can choose data from this form. So it can be create a new record from this form. So we click on OK. So after I have to give a table permission of educational information, so we go here and I click on permission, and here you can see I can already create a educational information. So let me give a permission to read the data, to update the data or create the data, and I can give the roles to the anonymous users for right now, and we click on save, and we have to click on save also. And let me cross this, and let me enter, or we can say we have to add our last step, that is a professional experience. For this step we also need another form, and that form name is professional experience form. So let me create that form also. So I hope you can create that form by your own by following this video. I can already show that how you can create a form in a multi-step form using a Power Pages. So after, let me add a last step, that is professional experience. For so I have to go add step. Let me give a step name, it can be professional experience, and that is a common table, that is online job portal. And after that I have to select a form, so it can be professional experience, and we click on OK. So let me give a permission of professional experience of multi-step form. So we go here, let me select permissions, and I can select the professional experience that I already create new table permission. So we click on this, and here you can see there is a name, that is professional experience. There is a table name, that is online job portal, and there is an access type. For now I can choose a global access. And let me give a permission to this form, so it can be read the data, update the data, or we can say create the data. Let me deselect the append to for now, and let me add roles, and it can be anonymous users, and let me cross this, and we click on save, and after we click on save, and let me cross this also. And after that I have to tell you that how you can add a feature to upload a resume in a multi-step form using Power Pages. For this we have to go on step setting, and let me go on attachments and enable attachments, and we have to, the attachment is required, and it also another features that you can allow to attach multiple files at a one time. And there is an attachment display name, so I can give a display name, so it can be please upload a file. After that I can scroll down, and there is a file type, can be all file types, and we click on OK. And let me update the permission of the table, so we go on permissions, and we go on professional experience, and I have to give a permission to append to. Basically append to is give the permission to append any attachment in this multi-step form. So we click on OK, and we click on save. And after, I have to cross this, and let me preview this form also. So let me enter a name, so it can be Tushar, and let me enter an email address, so it can be tushar@gmail.com. And there is a random phone number for now, and I can choose our address, so it can be Delhi, and we click on next. And it can be field of study, it can be computer science engineering, and there is a higher level of education, it can be bachelor degree, graduation year it can be 2023, and we click on next. There is a job title, so it can be web intern. And there is a company name, it can be XYZ for now. And there is employment start date, so I can choose a random start date. So I can go here, this Feb, and it can be 6. And employment end date, so it can be choose
this, let me upload a file. So I can go here, choose file, and let me select a resume also. So I can choose this and we click on OK. And after that, I have to click on submit. So here you can say submission completed successfully.
Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source of IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any question, don't hesitate to reach out to us. It's been a pleasure of sharing this information with you. So stay curious and keep learning.